Hello everyone. In this lecture, we'll be seeing the unsteady state and simultaneous material and energy balances. This is the unit number 5 of bioprocess care principles and calculation. So in this particular unit, we are going to see the topics on material balances under unsteady state conditions. So at the end of this unit, you should be able to analyze the steady unsteady state processes so that you can develop balance equations for material and energy balance independently as well as simultaneously. So in this direction, we are going to learn how you can develop these general unsteady state balance equations for energy as well as material in a batch operation. So we are going to learn the unsteady state material balance and energy balances through examples. So we are going to see the example from CSTR, that is continuous steady tank reactor, and a batch distillation, and a mixing case, which is again a CSTR with or without reaction. Under the energy balances, we will see how a solvent heating system can be developed, balance equation can be developed, also in a preheating of culture medium. These two are independent balance equations. If we have simultaneous balance equations for material and energy, so we are going to look into the examples of process with or without reactions. Specifically, we are going to look into drying operations where psychrometric chart for simultaneous analysis of material and energy balances, which is a plot. Psychrometric chart is a plot representing this particular phenomena. We are going to look into this. So going ahead, in the unit number 2, we have seen linear algebraic equations which have come out as a result of steady state balances where the reactions were not involved. Further, in the next unit, we involved the reaction and we ended up with the linear equations, independent equations, where we considered the reactions as generation and consumption terms. Further, in the unit number 4, which is not mentioned here, we have gone for energy balance equations. Similarly, in the unit number 5 now, we are going to have unsteady state equations where accumulation term comes into picture, which were not considered earlier and they were zero at that point of time. Now here we are going to use the term accumulation. If you do not have a reaction in the process, then this generation and consumption terms end up with zero, whereas they are not zero if there is a reaction. So a general material balance equation or energy balance equation can be written in a similar fashion. Mass rate of accumulation will be equal to the mass rate that comes in within the system and the amount that goes out of the system. So the difference between that, in and out, then how much amount of mass is generated and consumed as a part of a reaction process within the system. So it's a balance between the in and out, the balance between generator and consumption. The remaining item, it remains accumulated within the system as a function of time. Whereas in energy balance, it's exactly the same. Well, with the difference that this is the energy we are balancing here rather than mass. So that's what we have for this particular class. So we'll through examples in further video lectures, so we'll be checking out how do we do these balance equations. Thank you.